Hello everyone, welcome to ExamTest SQL Server Debate Tutorial. In this video, we are going to learn how to attach and detach databases in SQL Server. We'll be using two ways to attach and detach databases. One is using SQL Server Management Studio Graphic User Interface, that is a GUI version. And another is using T-SQL script. Just before you do this, I wanted to tell you that there is a could be different situation when you have to attach and detach the databases. One, if you are moving database from one server to another server, there are one way that you can back it up, and then you take the backup and restore the database on the target server. And other way, you could do the detach in the server in that database and take the MDF, which is the data file of SQL Server database, and take the LDF file, log file of the database to the target server and attach in the target server. That way database will be available right way. Therefore, that is other situation is that something is big organization will work with the vendors and they have their own databases and depending on their applications. And you get MDF and LDF from the vendors and you wanted to put that database on the particular server, you can get that MDF and LDF and attach that database with your SQL Server in-house, so that database will be available for the particular vendor in your own organization. Therefore, that is the second scenario, that where we could use the attach and detach databases. Third option, that in some time works really well, in that you are not using that particular database at the moment and you wanted to really store the database files because you don't know that if the particular database is going to be needed in future. Let's say your intention is to keep those databases data file and log file for 10 days, 20 days, or for a month, or for a year, and you get rid of these. In the case, you can detach the database and update the statistics so that your database is file will be available to attach in any particular instance of SQL Server database. Have it available your users, and way you can have the backup of your particular database. Means when we detach the database, it will be available in the file system, and we can attach that database to any SQL Server instance. So we are going go ahead and use the first SQL Server Management Studio Graphic User Interface GUI version. Let me open the SQL Server Management Studio. So this is my Management Studio. I'm going to connect with my Object Explorer. Here, server type, database engine. So database engine and server name is localhost because I'm running the database in local. Authentication mode, I'm using the SQL Server authentication. There is a server admin and I have a password. So I put it the password here, click on login or connect. So my database is connected. So this particular SQL Server database is connected. So now go to the databases. And there are too many databases are there. I want to detach the database. So for the detach the database, just right click on the database and go to the task and click on the option detach. So there is your options. So this is the detached database window. There is a general page there, and database to detach, there is a DVD rental. So before, if your database is going to in use, so we should drop the connections. So there is a, if I'll check, then that the running connection is going to be dropped, and use update statistics. So this will help to update the our database status, because if you have a time, then use the update statics, and if you don't have that much time, because it will take some time to update, and that depend upon your database size also. So I'm selecting this one and click on OK. So see here, database is not listed here, but if I'll go through the database file, let me this. Let me open Windows here. So I open the data files location. Here we can find the DBT Rental database. So this is my DBT Rental database. This is my DBT Rental database, and these files is not removed from the data file location, but that detached from the databases. Now next is how to attach the database. If database is detached, then we should attach the database. So right click on database and go click on attach. So when I will click on attach, so there is an option, there's a MDF file location. So if you want to attach the MDF file, so click on add. So on pop-up window will come, and there is your data files, and our file will be DBT Rental. So this is my data file. Before adding the data file, just be sure that you are adding the MDF file, not LDF file, because it will not show the LDF file. If you go to all file, so you can able to see the LDF file also. This is the LDF file, but we want to add only MDF file. So add the MDF file, click on OK. So MDF file is added here, and DBT Rental database detail is here. So this is my original file name, data types, file types, and this is the path. If your LDF file is not available on that particular location, then you will get a error. So you will get a big cross over here. Now click on OK. So now go to the database, right click on that and click on refresh. So you will able to see the your DBT Rental database is back here. So this is the first way we did that, and we detach first and then we attach the database, and data file will be available in our data file locations. Now next is using the T-SQL, we'll just detach and attach the databases. So go to the file and open file. There is a detached database script is there. So this is my script to detach the database. Use master, go alter master. This is my database name, set single user. Okay, and here I'm using to execute master.db.sp. This is the predefined procedure, sp underscore detach underscore db. So I'm providing the db name here. So just execute with the F5 or click on execute button. So command is successfully completed. So now refresh the page, refresh the databases. See, database is not available there. But if you go to the data file location and you refresh that, your data files are available here. Okay. So next, so this is the way to we can detach the database with the script, T-SQL script. And next I want to attach the database, so go to the option, open and go to the file. There is a, I have a script attached this database. So here, use master, then create database, dbt rental on, this is the file name, this is the file location exactly. So if anything goes wrong, just like if I'm putting the wrong file name, then how it will attach? Let's execute. So I'm getting unable to open the physical file, this file is not available, means the system cannot find the file specified, means file is not available there. Because if you go to the data file location and you see the dbt rental, one is not there. And so just remove one, give the original file name and go to attach, and for attach this is the command, execute this. So command is run successfully, completed successfully. Just refresh that and see dbt rental is available there for use. So this is the way we can use the attach and detach the file, and mostly this way we can keep the file for the long time if we are not using the our database, just like we are database is not in use. So we can detach the database and file will be available in our data path. So thank you for watching.